Hi, folks. My name is Vamshidhar Kommineni. I'm the Group Product Manager for Azure Object Storage. I'm delighted to have with me Danny Allan, the CTO of Veeam. Welcome, Danny.
Welcome. Glad to be here with you, Vamshidhar.
Great. So, Danny, our companies have had a long partnership together. Could you tell me, tell us and the viewers here a little bit about yourself, a little bit about Veeam and our partnership?
Sure. Yeah. So, I'm Danny Allan. I'm CTO and Senior Vice President here at Veeam Software. And we've had a very lengthy and robust relationship between our organizations. It goes back over a decade now. We did data protection or backup for the Hyper-V server, but over the years, you know, we've added backup for bare metal servers. And most recently, actually, we're seeing a lot of growth in the Azure front. So we've been doing backup for Azure native workloads, for Kubernetes, for Azure Stack HCI, and most recently, Veeam backup for Microsoft 365. So a lot of history between our organizations. Here at Veeam, we're very focused on making sure that we give our customers the confidence to move forward with their digital services and to ensure business continuity. Because, of course, data is what is powering our organizations, and you enable that data to be delivered, and we help to protect that data.
Yeah, love it. I mean, we've been very fortunate to have the partnership and grateful for the set of features that we can bring our shared customers. So let's dive into the topic of the day. We'd love to talk a little bit more about business continuity and disaster recovery. What does that mean for Veeam and for you? Love to get your thoughts on that.
Sure. So the way I think about this is there's really kind of three areas around business continuity and disaster recovery that we need to think about. The first is just secondary infrastructure. And as customers, if they move into Microsoft Azure, the secondary infrastructure might also be in Microsoft Azure in another data center or another zone. But we're seeing customers too, where they still have infrastructure on premises and they're saying, do I really need to maintain a secondary data center? And so they're using Microsoft Azure for that secondary infrastructure. And regardless of which type of customer that is, we can help support both of those scenarios. The second part of business continuity is the movement or portability of data, because of course, we're moving workloads from one area to another, and that might be movement from a physical server to a virtual server, or a virtual server to Microsoft Azure, or even bare metal. We're seeing people do this with physical laptops where they want to recover into a new location. And actually, one of the interesting things we're seeing, sometimes people in other clouds say, I want to continue my business continuity, and they move the workload into Microsoft Azure. So movement of data is a second big component. And then the third, of course, is expertise. Everyone thinks of the cloud as resource pooling or resource sharing. But one of the things that's most exciting to me, Vamshi, is the knowledge pooling. And Veeam has always been a 100% channel company. We work with partners who help organizations establish business continuity and best practices in ensuring that the business is fully resilient. But business continuity really is those three components to it: the secondary infrastructure, the movement of data from one place to another, and then the expertise required to enable that to happen.
Yeah, that's great, Danny. And then, you know, BCDR has kind of come back to the forefront of a lot of IT administrators and CISOs and CIOs as we think about the threat of ransomware and being able to recover from ransomware. So what is Veeam's sort of vision about this? What's the long-term view here? How are you approaching all the threats that our customers are facing?
Well, you know what I hear every single day: ransomware, ransomware, ransomware. It truly is a disaster. And like other disasters, whether it be floods or fires or hardware failures or data corruption, the key for the organization is to make sure that they have a survivable set of the data that they can bring back after that particular event. And the reason I say this, we just did a study, and 76% of the organizations that we spoke to had encountered at least one ransomware event in the last year, 76%. And I would argue that the one quarter, the 24%, may not be aware of the fact that they encountered ransomware. So clearly, this is a disaster that we need to impact. And we've been working with Microsoft for the last several years on this, introducing capabilities and features to help organizations. Because the one thing that I know, as we go forward into 2023 and 2024, we're going to continue to hear about ransomware. And so we need to think about ransomware in the context of security and ransomware, data protection by itself is not sufficient. I mean, obviously, we do need a copy of the data, but we need to think about things like verifying recoverability of the data, secure recoverability of the data. So while many of the things are the same as data protection, there are things that are unique to ransomware that we do need to consider to make sure that the business can recover.
No, that's a great point, Danny, that, you know, ransomware detection and recovery is about more than just, you know, data protection. So if somebody is looking at leveraging Veeam for these capabilities, what are sort of the top three things that they should be looking at? How should a customer, an Azure customer thinking about Veeam, think about, you know, these capabilities?
Yeah, the first thing, Vamshi, I would say would be consistency. So we protect, of course, on-premises servers and endpoints via Veeam backup and replication. But they may also have workloads in the public cloud in Microsoft Azure. And so we have the ability to protect cloud instances and file shares and databases. So you want consistency across those. And of course, you have SaaS applications too, like Microsoft 365. And so consistency across all of these different environments is kind of point number one. Point number two, I can't talk about disaster recovery and data protection without talking about the 3-2-1 rule, which is three copies of the data on two different media types, and one of which is offsite, so in Microsoft Azure. And we've actually added a one and a zero to the end of that because we believe it's important not only to have one offsite, but to make sure that one is immutable and that you have zero errors in that 3-2-1 scenario. So that's the second thing to think about. And then the third is verified secure recoverability. And there's kind of two components to that that are really interesting. The verified, we patented this concept of sure backup almost a decade ago, which is don't just take a backup, verify that that data can be recovered. And then the second is around the secure. We introduced this concept of secure restore, which enables you to integrate with your endpoint detection response or your antivirus solutions that you don't reintroduce malware back into the environment. And so making sure that you have verified secure recoverability is a key part of helping our customers to protect their environments.
Yeah, those are great points, Danny. Like having that consistency across all your workloads is so important. Obviously, offsite backups are really key. And you're talking about, you know, the secured and verifiable recovery. Those are great points. I'm curious just to dive into one of those in terms of offsite backup. Obviously, we've partnered together over the years on object storage and using it as that offsite storage location for Veeam backups. Can you talk a little bit more about what those key capabilities are of Azure Storage that you're able to leverage to deliver sort of the value and the requirements that customers have?
Yeah, absolutely. When people ask me what is one of the greatest strengths of Microsoft Azure Blob, I always say it's their footprint. You have data centers literally all over the world, and having the data close to where the workload runs is a key point. And not just having the data nearby, but the resiliency in the infrastructure that you've built. It truly is a testament to your engineering that you've been able to deliver that. So having that footprint around the world, the geographical distribution is kind of key point number one. Number two is around the compliance and governance aspect of this. I deal with customers all the time, Vamshi, that are, you know, in Germany or in Canada or in the US or wherever it might be, that data sovereignty comes into play. And so here's where Azure can help in a very meaningful way. You can make sure that the data that you're protecting stays within the boundaries or the compliance framework that you fall within. And, you know, after you get through the footprint and the compliance, then you get to all the cost efficiencies that Azure Blob brings. We have built into our product the ability to auto tier from hotter tiers of storage to colder tiers of storage. And so not only are we helping with the compliance and the security and the distribution, but we're helping the customers save money and do all the lifecycle management that goes along with that storage footprint as they mature applications through the lifecycle.
Yeah, no, that's great. And, you know, as we've kind of continued working together over the years, I think there's some exciting new things coming too. What are you excited about as our partnership moves forward in terms of what's coming up?
I get excited every time I talk with Microsoft Azure because you guys always have new things coming, but probably what is hottest right now is the immutability factor. So we've been looking forward to this ability to move data offsite, but also to make it immutable, because what does ransomware try to do? It tries to either delete your backups or it tries to encrypt your backups. And so with version 12, our next release of our product, we're going to be taking full support of Azure Blob immutability at an object level. And this will ensure that all of our customers have survivable copies of their data. We also have been doing a lot with you around orchestration. So we have a product called Veeam Disaster Recovery Orchestrator that is designed to help customers recover from, you know, disasters like ransomware. And we have many different capabilities built into that right now. You can recover from backups, you can use snapshot-based replication, you can use storage-based replication, continuous data protection. But there's two really key recoverability capabilities we're introducing in that. One is around cloud DR. We have the ability to help customers recover and orchestrate complex recovery into the cloud. And the reason why that's important is it's never just one VM, Vamshidhar, it's like 10 VMs and the directory services has to come up first, and then you have to launch your database, and you have to create your networks. And this enables you to recover into Azure. And the one thing I'll say about Microsoft Azure, your format is faster than all of the other clouds right now. And so this cloud DR scenario is especially powerful with Microsoft Azure. The second part of it is around clean DR. One of the hard things to do when you're hit by ransomware is to find the last known good copy of the data. It's a very manual process. And so within that product, what we're doing is we're starting on your last backup and we're testing it. Before you bring it back, we say, is that malware in there? And if it finds malware, well, let's go to the previous one. Let's go to the previous one. And so it automates what historically has been a very manual process, not only recovery of the data, but clean recovery of the data. And that's really important because you actually might need the core infrastructure that was hit by ransomware. That might be a crime scene. You might not be able to recover there. So this enables you to recover into the cloud in a very secure way while you're doing the forensics on premises.
Sounds like a great set of features, especially in terms of, to your point, being able to recover really quickly and get back up and running because there are mission-critical workloads that are affected for our customers. So with all of this work coming up, how do our joint customers, workloads on-premises, how can they start that journey with Veeam and Azure to the cloud?
So whether you're trying to do data center consolidation or create the secondary data center or getting out of the hardware business, what we're doing is we're helping customers both in the migration of this, but also ensuring the consistency of data protection and business continuity as they evolve through, you know, today's generation to the next generation. You take products like our Casting K10, which is in Azure Kubernetes Service. It helps customers to migrate from on-prem with OpenShift into Azure Kubernetes Service. So we enable this transition for the customer as they move forward with all of this wide range of enterprise capabilities. And I love the use cases around this. We have a customer right now, a large public healthcare organization. I can't mention who they are, but they were hit by ransomware on-premises. And thankfully, they had a copy of that data up in Microsoft Azure. And even though the ransomware took out their entire data center, and by the way, that included the Veeam backup and replication server because they had it in the same domain as their workload, which, by the way, you should never do that. We have best practices on how to deploy your infrastructure. But because they had an offsite immutable copy up in Microsoft Azure, they were able to bring that back up online while enabling, you know, the forensics team to come in and investigate their on-premises environment. So, you know, in the words of this customer, Veeam saved the day. But that's the type of scenario that we try to enable. Help customers move through that digital transformation and protect their data as they evolve the business forward.
Yeah, no, that's a great example. And you're right, Danny. The more we can do to help protect our customers and help them recover, the better. This has been a great conversation. Just to finish up, where should customers go to learn more about, you know, Veeam and Azure?
Well, you can always go to the Veeam website and drop down on solutions. It says Microsoft plus Veeam, but let me just throw up a QR code here online that will take you directly there. Like I say, it's been a very fruitful partnership, Vamshi. We love working with you. 10 years of experience and learnings and maturity that we're bringing to market. So it's been fantastic.
That's great. Thank you so much, Danny. Have a great day.
Thank you. You as well.